Hi, my name is Zoran Horvat. Welcome to another video in which we will talk about management of entity framework migrations. How do we design them? How do we apply them to any database, for example, production database, without having to stop the application during the process? So-called zero downtime deployment. So this is the only model we have, the person class. It has full name and birth year. We want to keep developing this application. Here is the application when we run it. We cannot make just any change to the database schema because obviously the application is using the database schema as it is now. So the technical request is to rename one column. How do we do that? We could change this property's name. That will be the new name for that column. And the problem will become obvious when we try to create the migration. Here is the migration script. It calls the SP rename stored procedure to rename the column. Well, that will create a huge problem to the old application, which is actively using the column under its old name. We cannot just apply this script to production while the old application is running. It will break. So again, what do we do? The first step, I will remove this migration and start over again. This is not a good way to go. The first step is to make the schema more general, and then when everything is over, when the old application is down, there's no old application in production anymore, you can remove the residue and complete the change. Now we start to dance around existing data. We introduce a new column for the very same data. This will be the new name for that existing column after the change is over. But I have to make it nullable because the old application, which is still running, doesn't know about this column. And it will populate that value in database with nulls when inserting new data or changing, updating, whatever, it will ignore existence of this column because it simply doesn't know about it. However, the new application must populate this value in every object. A new object will have both the old and the new property set to the same value. This migration is safe. It only adds a nullable column. You can always add a nullable column to an existing database. The old application will never break because of this. And here is what we see in the database after applying the migration. That was the cheapest of all DB updates. You can do this while the application is running. And the previous version of the application will still work fine. It doesn't know about a new column. Look at the select query. Birth year, full name. Those are the two old columns. And then I run the new application. You can deploy the new application side by side with the old one and start pointing users to the new application. It looks identical. The users will not see any change, but there is a difference. Here is the log. It knows about the new column as well. And if I inserted a new record using the new application and went back to see the log, you will see that the new application is inserting both columns. It is effectively supporting both the old and the new name for that same column. This is another example of slow migrations. If you watched previous episodes of this series about Entity Framework, then you have already grown accustomed to these slow migrations, migrations that could take days, sometimes months in production if you don't have the data to populate the new column. Here we do have the data, we should just copy it from the existing column, but look, it could take hours or days to migrate all the data into the new column. What I'm trying to say is that you can migrate the data in such a way that performance of the existing application, the one that is running in production, is never jeopardized. For example, if migrating data could affect performance of the application, then do it in many small transactions. Nobody cares. I'm just showing you the principle. I want to run this transaction once, and you will see that only 3 rows will be updated. But I want to show you a practical trick. Go to the model class which is affected, in which we are renaming the column, and introduce a method to migrate the data. And now comes the ingenious part. Cause the data migration inside the object when you get it from the database. If the field were null in the database, that will really change the object, and change tracker in the DB context will observe the change after read. Update the row in the database and you're done. But now you may say, oh, this is the get action. How can I update the database in the get action? Well, that's the trick. User cannot observe this side effect caused by the get. Did I change anything? Officially, no. The positive effect of this method of migrating the data is that effectively the users will drive the migration. The most frequently used data will be migrated first, and only the less frequently used records will remain. We can then use the background process, or we can use the background process all the time. And eventually, there will be zero rows affected, there's no more works to do, so the entire database will be migrated to the new schema. Now, if you like this video so far and want other users to find it at YouTube as well, the easiest way to draw attention is to like it. So please press the like button right now before we continue. Thank you. And now begins the final stage of the update, removing the old column because it is not used by anyone. Well, that is where the problems begin. The application is using it. If you remember, it is setting both the old and the new column. The first stage could be to point all user interface and model elements to the new column, so to effectively ignore existence of the old column. I have removed all mentions of the old column in the UI while you were not watching. And now we are facing the problem. We must remove this column and delete it from the database while the application is still running and effectively referencing this column as well. That is the problem. Now, there is a video which is only discussing the problem of removing the column from the table. I will not repeat that process because it is another lengthy piece of work, but watch that video if you have any second thoughts. The short story is that you remove this property. Here, the property is out. I'm creating the migration and watch out for the warning. This is the problem. Entity framework wants to set the default value to zero because it fears that there might be some null value still remaining in this previously nullable column. And so it wants to help us, but I don't like this way of helping. I will say, yes, we know that there are the data in the database, but none of the values is null anymore. So I'm removing the default value to make this migration fail fast in case that by mistake some record still contains null in this column. That must not be the case on any environment. So I'm forcing the decision to break the migration if the data are not clean in any database where I want to apply this. Since the migration went well, it's obvious that there were no remaining nulls in this column. We have completed renaming a column from the old name to the new name in about 4 individual steps. And through the entire process, we never had to stop the application to update the database. I hope you liked this video and other videos in this series about entity framework migrations. Please watch the other videos as well if you liked this theme. Thank you for staying with me to the very end, and see you in the next video.